Right, good morning everyone. Welcome back to GD and Son channel. I hope everyone's having a great day. So it is currently Tuesday. Yesterday I didn't really do much at all. I went out street scrapping first thing in the morning, about 5 o'clock. Found quite a few good items, you know, washing machine, tumble dryer, a few bits and bobs, brake discs, stuff like that. It wasn't a complete wasted journey. My neighbour also brought me back 2 boilers yesterday with loads of copper and brass on them, which I still need to strip down. He's also bringing me back a 3rd boiler today, which is absolutely great. Apart from that, my son was going on a leavers trip, so his end of year 6 trip, because he starts year 7 in September, he was going on this like leavers trip, so we decided we was going to go and see him off on the coach. He also forgot to take a few bits with him, so we had to go and drop them off at the school. We decided we're just going to stand there and, you know, wave him off. We're not going to see him. It's the longest he's been away from home for since he was born, basically. He's never stayed away more than, you know, a night. So he doesn't come back till Friday afternoon. So, yeah, that was quite nice, quite emotional, you know, hold back the tears. I know he's only going to have fun. It's like camping and, you know, shooting and stuff like that and building rafts and stuff. But, yeah, I do miss him. He's a lively character in our house, always making me laugh and cracking out jokes and stuff. So yeah, he's going to be missed until Friday. But anyway, today we've got quite a busy day. I'm going to go pick up some waste. I've got 2 waste removal jobs to go and do. One of them I haven't even seen yet. He's just basically said, you know, come round, quote me, tell me how much it is and I'll pay it. He's quite a nice fella like that. And the other one is, I've seen it, it's only a small load. A bit of carpet and stuff like that, stuff that came out of a shed clearance, I think it was. They just done their shed out. So yeah, we've got them 2 to go and do. I've got waste in my mum's garage we've got to pick up. I've got waste around my house that needs to go. I also need to drop off some metal today. So yeah, it's going to be quite a packed out day, and I've also got to give a quote for a first window clean. So yeah, anyway, first place we're going to is a place in Chatham. I've got to go and pick up some 25 litre water storage containers. Now, I'm not going to speak too much on this right now. You'll see what I'm going to be using these for later on in the week, so stay tuned for that video. But yeah, let's go and get them picked up, and then we're going to head straight down to the metal yard and get a load of metal dropped off. Let's do it. Well, here's my containers all picked up. Took up all the front passenger seats, so good job we ain't got Bill or anyone with us today. Gonna shoot down to APM now, so I've got metal on board. However, I have got like 2 boilers that are not coming off, and a small piece of aluminium which is going to stay on as well, because I need to clean it up because there's a few screws and that on it. So yeah, other than that, everything's coming off. I have got to smash 1 motor out of the washing machine, and there is a couple of cords that I need to cut. Other than that, everything else is already being stripped out. So let's head to APM and go and get this metal dropped off and see what we're going to get. So I'm not going to be queuing for long, guys. Just 1 car in our way, and then we're into the scrapyard. I'll get it set up when we're in there, and we'll get this metal unloaded. Right, so we just pulled up at the first job, everyone. Before I jump out and show you what we're dealing with, I thought I'd just run over the scrap metal prices with you. So went in there with 720 kg. We actually got shearing rate for all that stuff, which is absolutely brilliant. Top yard, APM over in Sittingbourne. Rate of £220 per tonne, which was a final sum of £158.40. Now, I am running a day behind, as I did have Monday off, so I am playing a little bit of catch up this week. 158 quid, you know, it is what it is. It's good money, but you know, it's not the best. I mean, if that's all you're going to, you know, if you can only do one or two loads a week and you're only getting sort of £150 a load, and you're only doing two a week, you know, that's only sort of just over £300 a week. So I do recommend if you are doing scrap that you try and do some sort of side business as well, hence why I do waste removal. And the window cleaning side of it is quite good as well, because, I mean, you know, when you go to do a window clean or something like that, you can upsell other products as well. You know, if you're there and you can see the gutters are a bit manky and stuff like that, you could say, look, whilst I'm here, usually I'll charge X amount for this gutter clean, but because I'm already here, I've got all my stuff with me, I've got all my equipment, you know, I'm willing to offer you a discount as well. You know, and it just helps to, you know, bring in a little bit more revenue. People think they're getting a good deal, which they are getting a good deal, and you're also getting a bit of extra money. You know, and then sometimes every now and again you're lucky enough to land like a pressure washing job, which could be, you know, a few hundred quid, depending on the size of the driveway. And, you know, it's just a constant stream of income. You know, you don't want, I don't like to just have my income coming in from one thing like scrap metal, because then I'm always relying on finding scrap metal. And if I go out like today, if I went out today and didn't find anything, and I went out tomorrow and I didn't find anything, I've lost kind of like 2 days' money there straight away. You know, and it can get tight, money can get tight, you know, it's we don't live in a world where everything's cheap now. You need to keep a constant flow of money coming in. So yeah, always recommend that. But yeah, good prices, APM Metal over in Sittingbourne. If you have got metal and you're in the local area, please take it down there, go and see them, because they are a great bunch of guys. Anyway, I'm gonna jump out and show you the waste. Right, so not much for the first little bit. Looks like an old dismantled shed. Nice streamer there with a wire attached to it, so we'll have that for the scrap. A few little bits and pieces. So anyway, what I'll probably do is I won't even bother setting you up, because I'm only going to be here for about 10 or 15 minutes. I'm just going to organize the back of the van. So yeah, here's a couple of boilers that we picked up from my neighbor. He's also bringing me another one back today, as I said. Lovely bits of cast in there, which I'm going to take out later on, obviously all the copper piping. These bits here, sometimes I try and just separate this little bit. Depends how easy it all comes apart to be, you know. I don't like scrapping things out to, you know, the very, very last bit. I have said this to people in the past, you know, I am quite a lazy scrapper, really. But yeah, we'll take this off, because they take all this as cast alley. So it's well worth the time doing it. So anyway, I'm going to organise my van a little bit, get this rubbish put on, and make our way to the next job. Right guys, so the van's all loaded now. We went and done the second job. I didn't film it because the lady comes out, she has a chat with me. She's a very nice lady. She's been signed off of work at the minute. So yeah, she come out, she's having a chat. I didn't really feel comfortable doing the filming as well. I know she doesn't want to be on the camera, so I respect that. Basically, all it was we picked up there was a bit of old vinyl from flooring. There was a few bits of metal, like a fan and stuff like that. A few little bits of plastic, you know, it wasn't a lot really, a little bit of old bedding. So we've got that on. We've also got the shed on that you saw in the first clip. When we were in my mum's garage, there was a few bits in there, a couple of matches that we've got to get rid of. Just been round to my house, we cleared out my son's bedroom not long ago, so we've got his old wardrobe to get rid of, chest of drawers, loads of old rubbish and stuff like that. So gonna head down now to the tip. It's coming up to lunchtime, so yeah, we're on track for doing. I've stopped at home for about 20 minutes, half hour, had a nice drink and that. It's just starting to get warm now. Then on the way back, I'm going to shoot round to Elsford, because I've got to go and do a little pickup. It's not scrap metal. I'll show you when I'm round there. You'll probably get a hint now of why I need these water containers. But yeah, let's go and do that, and we'll show you what we're picking up from Elsford. Right, rubbish is all being cleared now. Didn't quite make the half a ton minimum charge. I was at 440, so 60 kilo off, so you still have to pay the minimum, unfortunately. So I could have had another 60 kilo on there off rubbish and still got it for exactly the same price. Did have to pay an extra charge, obviously, for the two mattresses I had on. There is an extra charge at my yard for mattresses, and there's a few other things as well, like fridges, car tires, stuff like that. Mattresses are a fiver each extra on top of the price, so come to around about £100 to drop this load off. Not quite £100, but almost up there. Anyway, let's go and get my little collection from Elsford. Right everyone, so that's us finished for the day now. I didn't film what I picked up in Elsford, but I will tell you, it's basically spotless water. So there's a company called Spotless Water that purify all your water for you for window cleaning. The five drums that I had in the van with me is what I filled up. So I'm going to be doing a video in the next sort of couple of days, maybe the end of this week, showing you my first window cleaning setup that I've got. We're going to be doing a little bit of traditional slash water fed pole system. Yeah, quite excited to show you my little DIY. Well, I say it's a DIY, it's just a budget setup really. It's not nothing spectacular, but I will show you later on in the week. Just landed my first window cleaning job actually, every 4 weeks, £22 for a window clean. You might think that's a little bit expensive, but it's quite a big house. She's already an existing customer of mine, so you know, you can up the price slowly in time, you know, every sort of year or something, you can go up by a pound or so, you know, it's however you want to play it really. She's a very nice lady, and it's quite good for me just to practice, you know, on her house and stuff. She may be interested in having the frames restored. I did explain that obviously the window clean will get everything nice and clean, but you still might be left with a few marks here and there, as the frames, UPVC frames, may be a bit tarnished and stuff. So I may have to do some restoration on that, but it will be an additional cost. Also, I've got another window cleaning job on later on in the week as well, or beginning of next week. So I'll try and get some filming of the window cleaning done as well, so you can guys can see that. That's pretty much it really. So anyway, if you did like today's video, I know it wasn't that exciting, but please smash the like button for your boy, help us out. And I'll see you all on the next video. So take care, everyone.